Hoary bats are easily some of the most recognizable and charismatic bats in North America. Quite frankly, it would be hard not to like them. With their soft appearance and white-tipped fur from whence they get their name, they're simply beautiful little animals and probably one of my personal favorite bats. And I like a lot of them, so that's saying something. Now, there are three bats commonly referred to as hoary bats. The Southern or South American hoary bat, Lazieros vilosissimus, the Hawaiian hoary bat, Lazieros simotus, and the species I will be discussing in this video, the Northern or common hoary bat, Lazieros cinerus. All three bats look very similar and were until relatively recently considered the same species, adding to the confusion. For simplicity's sake, I will be referring to the Northern hoary bat as just the hoary bat for the rest of the video, as that is still the most common name used for this species. Hoary bats are one of the more sizable North American bats, and the largest member of their genus with a wingspan of 15.5 inches and weighing in at about 20 to 35 grams on average. Their long and narrow wings are designed to take them fast and far, which makes sense given their migratory nature. In fact, hoary bats are known to fly at more than 21 miles per hour, making them one of the faster bats in North America, only outsped by some free-tailed bats. Another thing to note is that like many other vespid bats, female hoaries are usually larger than the males. This may be an adaptation to accommodate pups. The hoary bat's scientific name, Lazieros cinerus, is derived from the Latin lazios, meaning hairy, and oros, meaning tail. The species name cinerus refers to the frosted appearance of their tricolored fur, being white at the tip, yellow in the middle, and black at the base. Unlike many other bats, hoaries have patches of cream-colored fur on several spots across their wings, with it being especially widespread on the underside. The actual skin patagia itself is an attractive reddish-brown and black. Hoary bats and their relatives are notable for having a furry uropatagium, which in case you didn't know, is the membrane between the legs. When roosting, the bats use it as a sort of built-in blanket, wrapping themselves up to keep warm. All this combined with their coloration help break up their outline and blend in with tree bark or dead leaves. Like I said earlier, the three hoary bats used to be treated as the same species until recently. A study in 2017 found that the ancestor of southern hoary bats diverged from the ancestor of the lineage that led to northern and Hawaiian hoary bats 4.61 million years ago. The ancestors of Hawaiian and northern hoaries then split from each other 1.35 million years ago. Interestingly, the study also found that northern hoary bats colonized Hawaii multiple times again after the Hawaiian hoary bat was already established, meaning that there are two bat species in Hawaii, not one. The two species seem to largely avoid hybridizing with each other, meaning that these newer northern hoary bats will speciate and evolve in parallel with the Hawaiian hoary bats rather than being absorbed. As tempting as it is to speculate about how this will turn out, that isn't the subject of this video and I will control myself. Traditionally, hoary bats are placed in the genus Lazieros with about 13 other bats. That said, some recent studies have challenged this classification, claiming Lazieros should be split into three separate genera: Aorestes, the hoary bat and big red bat, Dasyteros, the New World yellow bats, and what's left of Lazieros, the red bats and seminal bat. This is an interesting situation as you can technically get away with either splitting the genera or keeping them together, so how you classify them essentially comes down to personal preference. If you would like to know more about this proposed split, I'll put a link down in the description and you can decide for yourself. Personally, I think more data is needed before anything can be said with certainty, as the big red bat is most similar to the traditional red bats, but is genetically closest to the hoary bats, which throws a bit of a wrench in the reclassification. Hoary bats are one of the most widespread mammals in North America. They inhabit almost every part of the continent for at least part of the year, from Canada to Mexico, from Maine to the Channel Islands, and even all the way out to the Hawaiian archipelago. Chances are, if you look hard enough during the right times of the year, you will find hoary bats. Bargant hoaries also sometimes pop up in places like Iceland, Bermuda, and even as far as the Orkney Islands of Scotland. As for habitats themselves, hoaries are highly adaptable and can be found anywhere from hardwood pine forests, deserts, marshland, coastal forest, scrubland, and even venture into man-made habitats such as farmland. All that said though, hoary bats appear to have a preference for semi-open deciduous and pine forests, or the edges of woodland. This is likely because those habitats have plenty of trees for roosting in, while still open enough for them to pursue prey at full speed. The only habitat they seem to downright avoid are urban areas, probably because of the noise and general lack of good-sized trees for roosting. Like many bats, hoaries show sexual segregation. Male and female hoaries usually live separately for most of the year. Males remain in the mountainous areas of the western United States, distancing themselves from females and their pups. They even sometimes segregate by elevation, with males being more common in foothills and mountains while females prefer lowlands and valleys. That said, there is often some overlap and the sexes can sometimes be found in the same general areas. Female hoary bats give birth from mid-May to early July. Unlike most other bats, which usually only have one pup at a time, hoaries usually have twins. Less commonly, they can also have triplets and even rarely quadruplets. The pups first open their eyes and ears by 3 days old, fledge in 3 to 4 weeks, more or less fully flight capable in 6 weeks, and are fully weaned by 7 weeks. The youngsters become independent soon after. Hoary bats are often aggressive and territorial with other animals, males especially. They can be so aggressive, in fact, that they have been known to attack other bat species midair. Sometimes this can even escalate to the point of them even mauling the other bat to death. It should be noted, however, that things usually only get this bad when food is scarce and the bats set up strict territories. Hoary bats usually live alone, outside of mothers with their pups, until it's time to migrate. Their autumn migration is in late October, and spring migration is from February to May. At that time, both males and females travel together in loose clouds, sometimes containing hundreds of individuals. Their destinations are fair-weathered, mostly coastal areas, with most of the bats in the west ending up along California's coastal forests, and in the east from South Carolina to Florida. Many also overwinter in woodland along the Gulf of Mexico. Female hoaries seem to migrate farther generally, likely in search of higher quality prey, and some of the bats don't really seem to move much at all for some reason. Regardless, all that said, hoary bats still undergo the largest migrations of any mammal in North America, and most people don't even notice. Hoary bats are also unusual in that on top of migrating, they also hibernate. This is very unusual, as most animals just do one or the other. After the bats arrive in their overwintering spots, some of them just seem to curl up and conk out for a few weeks, even months in some individuals. Hoaries are also one of the only bats, and one of the few animals, known to hibernate out in the open. One bat, observed by Charles Rao, hibernated just a few feet above the ground on the bark of an Apache pine in the Chiricahua Mountains of Arizona. The bat slept through a snowstorm and survived temperatures as low as 7 degrees Fahrenheit. Hoary bats are insectivores that mostly eat moths, but flies, crickets, winged termites, winged ants, and true bugs are also consumed when available. In some localities, they have also been recorded eating mosquitoes, although this isn't a regular occurrence and is probably just the result of the sheer number of them buzzing around. Also, remember when I said hoary bats will occasionally attack other bats? Well, it has been proposed that hoary bats might occasionally eat these smaller bats when the opportunity arises. That's right, this little nugget could be a cold-blooded cannibal, except it's not really cannibalism because they're different species. Anyway, this is still debated, as it could just be over-aggressive males or even rabid individuals, given some of these assailants have later tested positive for the virus afterwards. Also worth mentioning is that hoary bats occasionally eat grass, leaves, and apparently snakeskin, according to the Mammals of the World Volume 9. Now, I have absolutely no idea what could possibly compel a hoary bat to eat snakeskin. Maybe it's like pork rinds or something, I who knows. The conservation status of hoary bats is uncertain. Although they are listed as least concerned by the IUCN, their cryptic habits of roosting alone in trees makes tracking down and checking population trends extremely difficult. One particularly dangerous human-caused threat hoary bats face is wind turbines. An estimated 76,000 to 152,000 hoary bats are killed by wind turbines each year. It's likely that they're also negatively affected by habitat loss and urbanization. I wish I could say more, but this is all the current information I could find on population trends, really. There isn't a lot. I want to give a special thanks to Sale for his help getting me off the ground. Your advice and help with editing was absolutely indispensable. He also has some great videos on world building, so if you're curious, I'd suggest checking those out as well. Obviously, this is my first video, and this will serve as a starting point for the channel. If there's any feedback you want to give, I'm all ears. Also, if I got any outdated information or somehow got something blatantly wrong in the video, feel free to leave a comment about it. I'm by no means an expert, and I don't pretend to be. I look forward to sharing more about bats with you all in the future. If you have a suggestion for species or topic regarding bats to cover, mention it in the comments below, and I might do a video regarding that in the future. I hope to see you all again. Well, not actually see you, but you understand what I mean.